Waukee grandmother experienced the unthinkable. Sherry Sinclair's daughter, Kelly Sly, killed her 2-year-old son, Gavin, then killed herself. Tonight, News Channel 8's Laura Nichols talks with Sinclair about how she is making a difference in suicide prevention.
We had a lot of plans for summer, and so it's very hard.
3 months ago, Sherry Sinclair's life turned upside down in the worst possible way, and now her daughter and grandson are gone.
Things aren't the same, and they won't ever be the same.
Sinclair's daughter, 23-year-old Kelly Sly, killed her 2-year-old son, Gavin, after giving him too much medication. Then shortly after, she killed herself by driving into this bridge pillar. Kelly, a single mom, struggled with a deep depression, and Sinclair tried to get her help many times.
There's always a lot of guilt that goes with it when you have someone that takes their own life.
Sinclair has since started going to suicide support groups and is hopeful that speaking out will help someone else.
I think one of the first things that I realized was that there's a lot of people that are struggling today, more so than you can even possibly imagine. And you just can't comprehend what it's like for them if you don't suffer yourself.
She says she realizes resources for mental health are scarce and diagnosis is difficult, but she hopes to bring awareness so that something positive can come from the unimaginable tragedy that she has endured.
Getting help is difficult, and you know, you have to really put forth effort, I think, to find out what resources are there and what would work best in your situation. You can't change what you've been through, but you can change things going forward.
Laura Nichols. And that was Laura Nichols reporting. Sinclair says her goal is to find peace with all of this. She thinks she can do that by helping other people. If you or somebody you know is thinking of suicide, prevention help is available.